I am stunned. This is one of the most exciting research works I have seen in quite a while. We thought that this was impossible, but scientists at Google DeepMind wrote an AI called Genie that makes a game from scratch. Almost. You give it an input image and look at that! You can now play with it. The input can be a drawing or almost anything you want. But all that is nothing compared to what just happened. That was version 1 that only supported these silly little platformer games. But that was just 9 months ago, and now here is Genie version 2. What can this do? Look at that. In goes an image, even a real or made-up landscape, and out comes a much more sophisticated game. Wow! Now, we always say that the first law of papers says that research is a process. Do not look at where we are, look at where we will be 2 more papers down the line. And now, we are 1 more paper down the line, so here is the moment of truth. And, by the way, by the end of the video, you will find that this AI is not really made because of video games. Not at all. I'll tell you about that, too. So, let's take Genie 2 out for a spin, and see what it can do through 10 amazing examples. And then we will also break it in unexpected and funny ways. You'll love it. Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai Fehér. 1. Do you remember Oasis AI? You know, creating a playable Minecraft world from scratch? That was amazing. But look. I mean, look away. And now look back. You're suddenly somewhere else. Why? Because it did not have long-term memory. This Genie 2 came out just a few weeks later, and look at that! Look away, look back. Yep, same scene. This one has longer-term memory. All this progress appears just a few weeks later. I can't believe this. Bravo! 2. This can create games with a variety of art styles and environments. So good. 3. You can control these characters with a keyboard, directional buttons, and jump too. And you get these lovely custom character animations. But you will see that there is more here. 4. Finally, these are actual 3D scenes you can navigate and play in. That's great news, because 5. You can even interact with these objects. You can open that door, shoot a barrel, or become a samurai. A really pixelated samurai, but a samurai nonetheless. And 6. NPCs, non-player characters, and interactions with them too, so you can get a sidekick or make a huge boss level for your players. I do not know what happened here. If you know, let me know in the comments below. And no, we are not going to forget about the 2-Minute Papers special. 7. Physics and smoke simulations. Wow! Yes, low resolution, but once again, just think about what we will be capable of 2 more papers down the line. By the way, gravity works too, so be careful out there, fellow scholars. 8. Look at that! Are you seeing what I am seeing? Lighting effects work really well, and so do reflections. Chef's kiss! So, with all this, 9. You can do really rapid prototyping. Go from an idea to game real quick. Should the game be about a paper airplane? Nope, it should be a hawk. Or wait, a dragon it is. Or just us. Anything goes. You don't have to invest a year and find out that the idea wasn't so good because you can create all of these games super, super quickly. And now, hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, because all this was just for show. Because ultimately, this whole thing is not about gaming. Yes, you heard it right. They built this AI not just to play video games, although that is quite nice with a Google DeepMind salary, I gotta say, but the real goal is to learn a world model. To be able to write a game, you have to understand how the world works, or even better, how a variety of different worlds with different rules work. And then, what do you do? Oh my! Here is SEMA. Yes, finally, they did exactly what I was hoping they would do. They let their gaming AI play in this environment. We can instruct it to go up the stairs or go through the middle door. This will be fantastic, because there are areas within AI that suffer from a lack of training data. Text is not one of them. you know, just read the internet. We also have lots of video data, there is YouTube and many other websites for that. However, what they don't give you is counterfactual information. That means what-if situations that start from the same starting point, but then different scenarios play out. And yes, baby, that is exactly what this system can give us. A training environment that can give you, for all intents and purposes, unlimited data. This could be used to train robots or self-driving cars safely in lifelike environments. They would be able to adapt to new situations in real life. Now, wait, we are not done yet, the best is yet to come, because sometimes unexpected and funny things happen in these environments. Fellow scholars, you are going to love this. You think you made a game about snowboarding? Nope, parkour it is. Or if you let loose a magic spell, you have to be ready for the consequences. Ooh, goodness. Or, get this, imagine going out for a coffee and reading a paper, and when you come back, wait, what? Is that a ghost? That is insanity. But in return, we will have self-driving cars that can deal with ghosts and destructive magic spells. I'll take that any day of the week. Thank you very much. What a time to be alive! So, what do you think? What would you fellow scholars use this for? What game would you make? Let me know in the comments below. To run your own experiments on an NVIDIA GPU, check out Lambda. I use it myself regularly for these videos. Look at that! You can generate high-quality images in less than a second per image. I did a ton more of them, and paid less than a dollar for all this. Crazy! Seriously, try it out now at lambdalabs.com/papers or click the link in the description.